Hello, I'm Huang Zheng. In the previous lesson, we have complete return claim number. In this lesson, we will continue to complete our claim and its claim.
First, we need to create a new data type mapping. Which is a key value pair. Our class uses the address type address, which corresponds to Boolean. Name it is claim. And set a visibility public. In this way, we create a key value pair. Mention that we can use message.sender to get the caller of the contract. Now we come to the claim function. If someone comes to claim the airdrop, wait in 360 days, set the message.sender of its claim to be true. And use mint to send the return value of function return claim number to the address. However, we still need to judge whether the address has claimed the airdrop, so we have to add a function return is claim. This function is very simple. It only needs to accept an address as a parameter and return the value of the is claim address. Finally, we come to the function claim. Use function return is claim to determine whether the address has received the airdrop and contract is completed. However, some of you may have a question that why the return value of is claim was not called directly in the claim function of if. In fact, it do can be called in this way in this contract, but when the front end connects to the back end, the front end cannot obtain the mapping value, and this can only be solved by calling a function. In the next lesson, we will come to the connection of front end to the back end. Thank you.